Good morning and welcome to the GHS Reporter. Today is Friday, September 6th, and I'm Sean Cunningham. Hurricane Dorian continues its path up the East Coast. According to CNN, the storm battered the coast of North Carolina and even created reports of tornadoes in the area. Some 5 people have been killed in the U.S., while the death toll in the Bahamas is now at 30. As we mentioned yesterday, the Global Impact Challenge is a unique opportunity for students to work together to improve their community, with the chance to win a $5,000 grant to implement their plan and maybe even win a trip to San Francisco for the award presentation. Here's Mrs. Chadwick with more information about Gilliland's participation and how you can get involved.
Hello everybody, I'm Mrs. Chadwick and I'm here to talk about an awesome opportunity that we have here at GHS this year. Wells Fargo and No Barriers are two companies that have created a program called the Global Impact Challenge. And what that challenge does is it allows students to look at our community, identify areas where inclusion or diversity are not what they could be or should be, and then fix them. We have the opportunity to look at our community and do what we can to help make sure that everybody has the opportunities that they deserve to have. So we have some awesome incentives that go along with this. There's the feel good of knowing what a difference you're making in not only your life, but in the lives of others. But there's also the potential that we could have our solution to our problem funded up to $5,000. And the winning team for this program will be given an all expenses paid trip to San Francisco next June. It's a real honor that we've been chosen to participate in this program because there are only 20 schools across the country that are involved in this challenge. So 20 schools will create teams that will then create plans to address diversity and inclusion in their communities. And of those 20 schools, one or two teams could be chosen. So the chances of us being chosen are really great. I'm looking to create a team of students who are willing to put the time in because it does involve a pretty serious time commitment between now and Thanksgiving. We have some flexibility and there will be an informational meeting after school on Monday, September 9th, to talk more about that. So if you are interested at all, you can email me in between now and then. Otherwise, show up to that informational meeting, which will be in the Student Center, room 600, right off the lobby, after school on Monday, September 9th. I look forward to hearing from you.
The girls' soccer team hosted their home opener yesterday against Saratoga. Just over 2 minutes into the game, Riley Grimm scored the only goal of the game, leading the Lady Dutch to a 1-0 victory. Molly DiCaprio had 14 saves, and the Lady Dutch are now 2-0 on the season. They play a non-league game here at home this afternoon. If you're interested in auditioning for the fall play Arsenic and Old Lace, come to an informational meeting on Monday at 2:30 in the auditorium. That's all for the GHS Reporter today. Remember to find today's announcements online and on Twitter at GHS Announcement. I'm Sean Cunningham. Today is a B-Day. Have a great day.